Hello.
Wake up, groupie. How about I take you up on that 10 kilometers challenge, Mr. America?
Yeah, now. Bring it on. 100 bucks. Can't do anything.
Meet me at the park in 20 minutes.
Okay.
Yo, man, what's up? You said 20 minutes.
Hi, Mrs. Renner.
My bad. I thought it was my friend. What? No. That can't be right. There must be a mix-up somewhere. Okay, you know, why don't we get another opinion and see what... You did already? Now, there must be a mix-up somewhere which I'm going to sue someone for! Let me just check my email and I'll revert. Yeah, bruv. I'm almost on the third mainland bridge. Yeah, almost. Let me get home first and then I'll call you. I'll call you later, bruv. Alright. Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
Listen to me, darling.
What? For what?
Okay, don't do this to me. Nero, please.
Hey, mom, that will cut it. Okay, that won't cut it. I want answers and I want answers now. Okay, because that won't even cut it. Besides, does that know? Is that aware, mom? Is that aware? Mommy, talk to me now. Is that aware?
So far, but me, Jenny, you want to destroy everything that I've built in the past 32 years. Calm down. Just listen to me.
Let me just start talking now, mom. Start talking now before I start any of your dirty laundries in public.
I expect you to understand. Calm down, please. Don't do this to your mother. Please, joke on me. What am I supposed to, even say?
Your phone they ring, you know. See, I no go score you for this. No go.
Oh, yeah, I'm Benzema, man.
It's my dad. He's been calling me for the past 4 days now. I was so forced to send him a text message that I was gonna see him tomorrow.
Come.
But I was chilling with the guys.
Yo, Mumsi has not told him yet. Guy, you have to be serious. So check well. No mistakes.
Oh boy, the DNA test result is right there in my email. I just don't know how to feel. I feel like I've been living, my whole life is just a lie. The man I looked up to, the man I called a father, is just no more my father, all because of a mere coincidence. What if I didn't start the green card process?
Yeah, you know for no way your papa being.
I could strangle my mom right now, she's so evil. Just think of the fact that she'd always, you know, insult and yab me like I have the big head of my dad or my...
Wait, do you think you might be the only one? You know, because that your sister, sometimes she used to confuse me. On Monday, she's yellow. Tuesday, she's black. She's not looking like Bolly.
You mean like Tony is not that?
Come on, man. Don't act like you haven't, you know, it hasn't passed your mind.
No, it never crossed my mind. Never. We see, that one is not even difficult. What we can do is get their DNA test results without them knowing.
Wait, that's that thing you use a cutting board and be choking inside somebody's mouth?
Chris, it's a lot more easier right now. Mm. Okay, we can actually get the samples without them knowing. Yeah, I can get Mrs. hair from my hairbrush and then chewing gum given to Tony with, you know. You see, all of that is even too easy compared to the ordeal I'm about to face.
Finding your real dad?
Yeah, that and also facing my dad tomorrow. Oh, hey, man. Thanks for letting me hang with you.
Come on, man. Small thing. What are brothers for? No be your side that they stay when they come, Yankee. See, don't go too emotional and say Benzema no go give you for this game.
No problem. Let's sort it out.
Oh, yeah. What, Benzema? What? Benzema! Go!
Do what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Hey.
Ah. Ekun.
Daddy.
The eagle was landed.
Oh, I miss you, Dad.
Well, you're supposed to sit now and eat with us. After you've been eating all those White Castle and McDonald's. Mommy, please tell Deborah to turn amala for this young man so he can eat something from home.
Thank you, Dad. I'm sorry I can't join you. I actually told Toyin that I would pick her up at our hostel for lunch. So I'm just here to help her collect one of Mom's designer bags.
Hello, Tony, my beautiful young fashionista.
Fashionista, yes.
Okay.
She's not serious. So it's my bag she wants to be posing around with on campus. Hmm? I don't have any bag to give her. I'm sorry.
Mom, where's the bag?
Well, I used it yesterday. It should still be in my bedroom on the chair. And please empty all the contents, especially my money.
Thank you, Mom.
What's in the bag that I cannot use?
My money.
Ah, there you go.
Daddy.
Come on. I was wrong, didn't
I? Uncle Iko.
When did you get in?
Just last night, Uncle.
Wow. Hey, Ronnie, give me to me.
Vijayaraniel, in the Boston, he returned. He made himself scarce. And now he's leaving again.
Come on, Dad. But you know it's your fashionista I'm going to go and meet.
Right, Jerry. All right, Ura Olami. You know, you're just ever looking gorgeous. I told you, we Egyptians, we take care of our women. Just look at you.
You know, talk is cheap.
Why? Leko, you're lucky to meet me here. You never told me you were coming.
Anyway, on a more serious note, I didn't think you were going to be at home. I just was in the neighborhood and I thought, I'll come and see how I was. But since she has disagreed that Egyptians don't take care of their wives, how could I believe it?
No, it's not like that, Joku. So what can I make for you?
Yawo tun bi mi ni. Pande jam, ma pe jare. Iyan to ro dada.
You know what you give this one now? You have to give him iyan, you know.
Enough to know that you're planning a very big wedding.
Good to see you.
Hello, nice sweetheart. See you. Oh, see here. Oh, you too.
Okay, that's it. Stop flirting with my brother, okay?
It's all right. Oh my goodness. So good to see you.
You bring my bag?
Yeah, sure. I brought everything.
Okay.
Say.
I'm serious. Like, she's actually very naughty. She just likes to be naughty.
Wow, there's no harm in being naughty. Okay, there's actually no harm in that. I guess that's why you both get along so well.
Haha, very funny. What do you mean by that? I'm not naughty.
Well, naughty, not so much. But mischievous, very much so.
Well, if you put it that way, there's a truthful ring to it.
I miss you, sis.
I missed you too. So, how come your mother did not kill you when you asked her to give you the bag?
No. But you said, why do you need a bag?
Mm-hmm. You care for one?
Yes, please.
I just asked you if you wanted one. I didn't ask you to confiscate the whole thing.
You're not even happy that it's only gum I'm taking from me. If you were a girl like me, you'd be traveling only in the clothes that you're wearing.
That place right now is extremely cold. You know you like cold weather.
No,
the stream, the stream you passed through to my house is frozen already.
Thank you.
Ooh, this is nice. Give me that chewing gum, because I know if I don't collect it from you now, you're going to put it under the table. Give it to me. Give me. Give it to me. Put it here. Listen. Eating chewing gum as if.
I know you think I was
going to
stick it on the table, because that's what Judy does, Abby. Speaking of Judy,
yes.
Oh, wow. When is the wedding? I mean, I'm guessing you want to propose. I mean, you even proposed to him. That's why you came in to come and see mom and dad so quickly.
Hey, listen. Julie is fine. She's doing good. And she can't wait to see you. She wants you guys to come around and hang out, go shopping and all the regular stuff. And hey, no, I haven't proposed yet. So leave it at that.
I don't know.
You have to be ready here, here, and here.
Because if you're not, you go a long way.
It's okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
I'm looking at Lord of the Rings.
Enjoy your meal. Yes, sir. I'm actually on it now as we speak. Yes. Yeah. Please come in. Yes, sir. Thank you very much. We'll be in touch, sir. Thank you. Have a seat.
Hi, Doc. You're back so early.
My dear, today has been one hell of a day. Actually, you can say that again. You know, I have to reschedule my meeting. You know, this Lagos traffic, since the introduction of bike ban, my dear, it's been chaotic. Yes, because midway, I had to turn back.
You can say that again. But you know those bikes are the major cause of accidents in Lagos State.
My dear, you can try telling that to my wife. Yes, because she's convinced that these are the necessary evils.
This is worse.
Back here, my dear. So, any calls?
Yeah, just irregular inquiries and a particular call about a test.
The test results. You know, the wait is usually the period for anxiety, isn't it?
True, very, very true. But Mr. Ajanoku was here today, although he had the samples with him.
That's fine, Busayo. That's very fine. You know, I've been expecting those samples. You mind if I have them?
Sure, yeah, there you go.
Yeah, Chris, what's up? Yeah, I got the samples that I've taken into the clinic already. Oh, thanks, man. It wasn't as difficult as I thought initially. I got the hair samples from mom's comb, then dad's toothbrush, and then chewing gum from Tony. All right, thank you. I'll see you tomorrow, as I have to face my dad later tonight. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Olani wrong. You are a fish head. You know, you are just like your Uncle Lekon. Lekon can sell his birthright for a fish head.
Dad, I'm not that bad. Come on.
I'm just telling you. Oh, by the way, how is Judy? At least now that your mom has agreed for you to, you know, marry a white girl, how soon will I become somebody's father-in-law and a grandfather?
Not you too, Dad.
Ah. Oh, so your mom has been on your case for that too?
Not even mom. It's Tony. She says she can't wait to organize a wedding party.
You don't blame her?
Demola,
yes,
did you take my comb?
You hear your mother? Your comb? Yes. What will I do with your...
Sweetheart, it's just a yes or a no answer. Did you take my comb?
But mom, you have your ghillie on already. What would you need a comb for?
All right, sweetheart. The answer is no. What will I do with the comb?
Demola, it's just the two of us in this house. And I know you took it. Hello? Oh, yes, darling. I'll just pick my bag and come. Just wait for me out there. All right, darling. I'll be with you now. That was Mrs. Buckner.
Okay.
Let me get my bag.
Dad, mommy still goes for this meeting.
Ah. Who is to stop Mbabaduati, the wife of Ajenoku? Who's going to stop her? Of course she does.
She loves that meeting so much. Ah. After all these years, she's still going to do all those meetings. She goes.
I hope you two are not gossiping about me.
Gossip, ke?
Gossip.
No, I was only telling your son that I have to help look for your comb before you come back.
Uwanarai. Emurasi. I'm off now.
Bye, mom.
Bye, darling.
Well, you have fun.
Yes, she.
Urola urustic.
So, mom, has mom always been this troublesome?
Ah. Always. Ah. Always. She's having calm now. Ah. Urola konjokmokon. Oh, by the way, please remind me so I can tell her your Uncle Lekon, you know, bought her own ashwebi.
Oh, really?
Yes, for, you know, I bought your mom's own ashwebi.
Oh, that's so nice of you. That's really nice. But Dad, you said they're always, how close were they?
Very close. Very close, since we're living in the States. You know, living there, studying there, we were very close. And he doesn't joke with your mom at all, you know. See, let me tell you, when Grandpa passed, and I left there to come to Nigeria for the burial rites and all that, it was Lekon who took care of your mom for the 2 weeks that I was absent from the States. Took good care of her.
Wait, Dad. Did I travel with you at that time?
You? No. You were not even born then. No.
So it was just mom and Uncle Lekon?
Oh, yes, yes. And it got closer after, you know, after she moved in with him. You know, I always teased your Uncle Lekon about having something, you know, having the pain for your mom. Can you imagine that? We're quite close. Are you okay? Are you all right?
Oh, yes, Dad, I'm fine. I just remembered that I have a meeting with Chris at 3.
Okay.
I was wrong, didn't I?
When did you get in?
Just last night, Uncle.
Wow. Hey, Ronnie, get the baby to me.
Oh, by the way, please remind me so I can tell her your uncle Leko, you know, bought her own Ashore B.
Oh, really?
Yes, for you know, I bought your mom's own Ashore B.
Oh, that's so nice.
You are a fish head.
You know, you are just like your uncle Leko. Leko can sell his birthright for a fish head.
Dad, I'm not that bad. Come on.
I'm just telling you.
But Dad, you said they're always close. How close were they?
Very close. Very close. Since we were living in the States, you know, living there, studying there. We're very close, and he doesn't joke with the mom at all. You know. See, let me tell you. When Grandpa passed, and I left, you know, and I left there to come to Nigeria for the burial rites and all that, it was Lekon who took care of the mom for the 2 weeks that I was absent from the States.
Did I travel with you at that time?
No. We were not even born then.
So it was just mom and Uncle Leko?
Oh, yes. And they got closer after she moved in with him. You know, I always teased the Uncle Leko about having something, you know, having a pain for your mom.
Ura olami. You're just ever-looking gorgeous. I told you, we Egyptians, we take care of our women. Just look at you.
You know, talk is chill.
I got the result.
What result?
Dude, the DNA test result.
Tell me now, are you waiting for me to ask you?
Tony is dad's.
Hey, that's good news. I mean, we're looking for only your pops now.
Yeah, that's right.
Hey, what about your mom? Does she know anything, any updates, you know?
Well, my mom, she's doing her best to avoid me and at the same time act cool about it. Think I know who it is.
That's good. That means you have a lead. Who is it? Let's get to work.
I think it's Uncle Leko.
Come on, man, you know, Uncle Leko. Uncle Leko can't be your father now, Uncle Leko, huh? Come on, man.
Dad told me.
Wait. Your dad knew what thing happened?
You want to kill him? Of course not. We're just talking on a general note and he was saying how close Momsi and Uncle Leko were. So I just put two and two together.
Oh, Nero, there you go again. Two and two together equals five in your book. Come on, Farabale, we'll see what will happen. We'll get to the bottom of this.
However crazy and however painful this might be, I'm just going to find out the truth.
Don't worry. Me, I did your back. As I did the back of this, our new gym instructor.
Thank you. Hey, cousin, your fly.
How's everything?
Wait, just wait for me.
Eh? Now, whatever they use now.
My driver care. This one a giddy car.
Wow.
You don't see how it's tight. Yeah, very alright. I wasn't expecting to see you because Uncle told me you no longer live.
Yeah, I don't stay anymore. I just came around to pick some food. Must cook for me.
Auntie's egusi soup she loves is always on point.
She loves cooking. She loves cooking.
Yeah.
Anyways, I have to go now. I will be in US sometimes in June. One of my closest friends is doing his 30th birthday. And like seven of us will be in Vegas.
Oh boy, that sounds like fun, oh.
Exactly. Like, you should join us.
I join you guys. But I should do it because people keep saying I work a lot without play. And you know what they say?
Yeah.
What happens in Vegas?
Stays in Vegas. Then I should send you some details, like details to the event and probably hand it to the WhatsApp group.
Oh,
what do you think?
Yeah, that sounds like a plan.
Yeah, man, I have to go now. All right, bro. You can let yourself in.
Okay.
Hustle is in the compound.
Okay, there is.
Yeah, sure.
All right,
bro.
Hey, God calls, man. All right. It's good to see you, big
man,
boy.
Good to see you too. Yeah.
Uncle.
Ah. Hey. Ah, JJ. I want to come here. Go.
Thank you so much.
You just missed your cousin Dele.
Oh,
just
Dele, no, Uncle, I didn't miss him. I actually saw him outside, so we had a little chat before I came inside.
Okay.
Uncle, I brought this for you and Auntie.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. Hey.
Yes, Uncle. How is Auntie? Where is she?
She's okay, but she's not in the house right now.
Oh.
And I'm sure you'd have loved to see her.
Uncle, I would have loved to see her, because I kept thinking about that egusi soup when I was on my way.
Jerry. I know you'd love to have some of it.
Yeah.
Of course, you are in luck now. She actually made some for Dele before he left the house. Yeah. I'm sure there's some left in the kitchen somewhere.
Oh, okay. Uncle, there's a vanity kit in there. There's even a nail cutter. Look at it.
Ah. Okay.
Sometimes those nail cutter don't. But I'm sure this is a very good one. Here, you can try it.
Even looks it, you know, because the ones we see in Nigeria are not so.
Yes.
Let me try it.
Why don't you try it, Uncle? Uncle. Don't put it on the floor.
Oh.
Don't do that.
You and this is your American way.
Yeah.
You know, we have been back a long time. So
it would have been an amazing one. But besides that, Uncle, I came here to see you for something quite important. Yes, Uncle.
I hope it's not serious, Uncle.
Nah, it's nothing serious.
Ah.
You know, Mommy's birthday is coming up and we're trying to plan a little surprise for her. So I just came to ask you a few questions.
That's good. I'm always available. Just whatever you need before, ask.
Oh, okay. But in fact, why don't you do the other leg?
I was thinking this particular thing.
Dad had even told us quite a number of things because he had told us how they met, their early stages, when they caught and everything. But since you are Daddy's cousin and you know more about Momsi, maybe you will just tell us a few good things about
You know something? I don't joke at all with your mother. She means a lot to me. Yes.
Really?
Wonderful woman.
Uncle, let me help you with this.
There's even a bin in the
kitchen. This place is open, Nabi. Let me help you out. Okay. I'm coming.
All right. this is really nice.
Yes? No, I'm at my uncle's place.
It's okay.
It's not so far, but I can... You know what? Let me call you back. Uncle, unfortunately, I have to go now. Something just came up. I forgot I was supposed to meet up with my friend to have a drink with him, so I gotta go.
I don't know, but I thought you said you wanted to see your aunt.
Yes, I need to see her, but you know, I'm still around, so I can always see her another time.
All right, no problem.
So I have to run, Uncle. Thank you very much.
Don't be a stranger.
Of course not. I'm still going to come and see you. All right, Uncle.
All right.
Bye.
Bye, Jay.
Hello? Yeah, I'm on my way now.
That's unbelievable for the kids of nowadays. In our days, how can you even try such a thing? You live in an elderly man sitting to say that you want to go and meet up with an appointment with a friend just to do what? To drink. Anyway, it's only democracy. It's your time. Let me see what they have here. Listen, I really need these things though. Ah, hey. Perfume, Tom. Wow.